Grace and peace, and welcome back to our Kingdom Nugget series. We are delighted once again, as always, to be here. We're in our throne room where we're just embracing the presence of God, and we're just ready to just dive into the Word of God, and we're going to say our word of prayer. Some may be wondering, why are we always opening with what we know as the Lord's Prayer? But that prayer is fully loaded. If you recite that prayer and get it in your spirit every day, that prayer is fully loaded. So that's why we start off with that prayer. So you can even join in with us as we pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. All right, so we're going to pick back up. Last segment, we were talking about strongholds and pulling down the strongholds and how as kingdom citizens, we have spiritual authority to be able to cast down strongholds. And we talked about strongholds being those lies and that come in our thoughts and emotions, mm-hmm. and they're lies, but then we start accepting them to be truth. And then we have to reject them. If we know that they're not true, if we know that they're not of God, we should not be storing those lies and those things that build up and can cause strongholds to be in our minds. So mm-hmm. we were in 2 Corinthians, and we were talking in 10 and talking about casting down those strongholds, because our weapons are not carnal, but they're mighty through God. Right. So the Spirit of the Lord is really breathing upon these segments now, and God is really illuminating things to us that people are dealing with. Right. You know, strongholds are a issue in the kingdom of God, and God really wants us as the kingdom citizen to pull down those strongholds. Right. We don't have to walk around in bondage in our minds. And right. so many people are dealing with anxiety and depression. And, you know, it's so many kingdom citizens that's on
the antidepressants.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think that the biggest thing is to realize we all have strongholds that we have to deal with, because we are still dealing with this flesh. So at a moment, any moment, it can happen to any of us. So none of us are any better than the next person. What we have to realize is that we have to live this life every day. And Philippians 4 shows us how to live this life. Mm-hmm. Philippians 4 through 8 is our scripture for this evening. And it's gonna read 4 through 8. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things.
That's a lot right there. That's a lot. And I love how that started. It said, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. And even that jumped out to me, because this is our year, and we've been talking about mm-hmm. it in the sanctuary. This is our leap year.
Yes, right.
This is the year that we rejoice. This is the year of Jubilee, when right. God resets. He allows us to have a divine do-over. Right. And so whatever we need, we shouldn't be, you know, anxious about anything. But it tells us further down, it says, be careful for nothing, be anxious for nothing. Mm-hmm. But in everything, with prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving. And we talked about a couple of segments ago, thanksgiving is a weapon.
That's
when
right.
we give thanks to God, that's a weapon to keep, you know, keep those thoughts down, keep those things down that are not like God.
That's right. And I think the biggest thing is, and you know, we can equate it to our computer. And when we say we have problems with our computer, I would say hit Control Alt Delete, and you can reset everything. Mm-hmm. And that's what God is doing in this year, is resetting everything mm-hmm. for us that we need cleaned up. So if there's things that we're having issues with, we're having stronghold issues, this is the time. Now is the time to leap beyond those strongholds mm-hmm. and really put those strongholds in captivity. Yes. Because that's the whole purpose, is for us to cast down those imaginations.
Yes.
And then while they're cast down, we place them in captivity.
Yes.
So we just can't allow it to be cast down. We have to place it in captivity. Because
yes.
we cast it down today, then you gotta cast it down tomorrow, you gotta cast it down the next day. Those strongholds are really being empowered to come back because they're not being placed in captivity.
Yeah, well, and I just heard when you were saying that, is the scripture that talks about he's giving us keys to the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
So being kingdom citizens, we have keys to get in and access the power of God.
Right.
And so he said, whatsoever things we bound on earth mm-hmm. will be bound in heaven, mm-hmm. and whatsoever things we loose on earth. So when you talk about placing those things in the captivity, we're binding them. We're tying them up. We're telling them, you don't have a place here.
Yeah.
You don't have legal right and authority to even occupy space in my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And so then when it goes down to verse 8, because we don't want to leave this out, it says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true.
Mm-hmm.
So when things come into our mind
mm-hmm.
and we got to test it against the word of God, is that true?
Yeah.
Did God say, I'm never going to have a mate, or I'm never going to have,
mm-hmm.
did he say that? And if you cannot find that in the word, then you know it's not true.
That's
but
right.
It says, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest. Okay. So now we got to deal with honesty.
That's right.
If it's not honest,
it's lies.
Yeah,
lies.
It's lies. And we shouldn't be storing those
That's
things.
That's right. We know who the father lies.
Yes.
Are.
So we got to look at this. Whatsoever things are just.
Mm-hmm.
Whatsoever things are pure. Is it a pure thought? Is
mm-hmm.
that thought something that if we had a loudspeaker hooked up to our mind, that we wouldn't be embarrassed to have that coming over the loudspeaker?
Is it N-O-G? If it's not of God, then it does. And that's a plug for Evangelist Max. If it's N-O-G,
yes.
it's not pure.
Right. So if it's not of God, that's good. And so whatsoever things are lovely.
Right.
So if I think about something and it's just thoughts of that if we could go back to our healing heart session,
mm-hmm.
does it make our heart be full of faith, hope, and love?
That's right.
You know, whatsoever things are lovely. Whatsoever things
report.
Of a good report.
Mm-hmm.
So if it's something that's coming, there's a scripture in the Old Testament, I believe, says, whose report will you believe?
That's right.
And we're going to believe the report of the Lord.
But that's a good report.
Yes. So even when we get reports saying, you know, oh, the doctor's saying, doesn't look good. Well, that's their report.
That's right.
But then we're going to believe the report of the Lord. That if we do what's right and reverse some things and do get some things in order, because we do have a part.
Oh, yeah.
So we're gonna believe the report of the Lord. If there be any virtue. And lastly, if there be any praise. And again,
That's
praise
right.
is a weapon.
That's right.
You hear a song that says that? My praise is a weapon.
Right.
So when we start praising and exalting, lifting up the name of Jesus, those things are the things that we should be thanking on. So kingdom citizens and those that are striving towards kingdom citizenship, we want you all to use these principles, use these words of God, even in your prayer time. Pray the word. You know, you should be in Philippians 4. Whatsoever things are lovely, Lord, whatsoever things are true, Lord, if it be any virtue, any prayer, let me think on these things.
Right.
Because we do have dominion over the spirits that are trying to get us to be downcast and depressed and all that. We got to rebuke those things and take authority as kingdom citizens. So again, as always, we're getting just so plugged in to what God is saying. And we're just going to take authority even before we leave this session, that Father, in your name, we just ask that all of your people, Lord, everywhere that are viewing this and that are even discussing your word, that they will know their rightful place in the kingdom. They will know the authority they have in your word, that they can be able to rise above every circumstance and every situation. And we're just going to believe, God, that his shalom, which means his peace, nothing missing, nothing broken, nothing lacking, will be in your dwelling. And so until next time,
live on purpose.